Let's see how to add and remove edge loops to a model in Blender. Here I have a single object that inside has a cylinder and a cube. I'm gonna select it and go into edit mode. To add edge loops, we press Ctrl R and move the mouse to a part of the model. Then, depending on the part where the mouse cursor is, the cut will be made in one way or another. For example, here the edge loops would be circular because the geometry near this part is circular, the basis of the cylinder. But if we approach this other part, for example, here the cut changes. In the case of the cube, for example, the edge loops would have this shape. With the mouse wheel, you can increase or decrease the number of subdivisions. When you want to confirm, press left click. Notice this window. Here you can modify the parameters of the operation. And now you can apply new subdivisions, but taking into account the new geometry. I wanted to mention two very useful things when working with edge loops. The first one is how to select them easily. This is done by holding the left Alt key and clicking on one of the edges that compose the loop we want to select, for example this one. This way we can easily select the loop, and if we hold Shift we can select several loops. Another very useful thing is the proportional editing, this icon here that we can activate or deactivate pressing O. With this option you can apply a transformation on a set of vertices, and that transformation will be transferred to the neighbors with more or less intensity depending on the size of this circle that you can control with the mouse wheel. With proportional editing you can achieve this kind of effect in the model. Proportional editing also applies to changes in position and rotation. So, we saw how to create edge loops, now let's see how to remove them. The first step would be to select the loop that we want to remove. In this case, I press Alt and I'm going to select this loop. To remove it, press X and in this window choose Dissolve Edges. This gets rid of those edges but merges all the geometry around it. Be careful because this operation brings issues if you select adjacent edge loops as in this case. Know that if we dissolve these edge loops, Blender doesn't have much information to determine how to connect the resulting geometry, so this kind of thing happens. An alternative would be to select edge loops, keeping an unselected loop in between. So now, if we dissolve the edges, we get a good result. That's all for this video, I hope you found it useful, and see you in the next one. Tschüss!